This program is brought to you by the Stanford Humanities Center. For more information, please visit us at shc.stanford.edu.
From the point of view of scholarship, digitization has changed everything. It's changed the way that we work and access these materials. It has raised the stakes in terms of an appreciation of our cultural heritage. Text Technologies on Stanford campus is situated in the Centre for Spatial and Textual Analysis. It is a very open project dealing with manuscripts and early printed books particularly, but also human communication from the earliest times to the present day in all languages. Within the Text Technologies sort of portmanteau project, which has a number of smaller projects underneath it, initially we're driven by the interests of individual faculty and students. And by the receipt of external funding from the NEH, for example. I also work with Professor Egan on campus and other medievalists, and then medievalists and text technologists from around the world. What is really important for text technologies is the development of digital tools that allow us to use new approaches and methods to create new knowledge effectively. So, for example, I could do a quantitative codicological study of the letter E and its positioning, and that sounds like a bizarre thing to do, but in other words, one would analyse digitally and count the numbers and different forms of E to determine how the very beginnings of script changes happened in the 12th century.
My own research is on pre-modern Chinese literature. The interest that I have is in everything from the actual writing systems, to book production, to manuscript production and transmission and preservation. All of this counts as text technologies.
You would also use digital tools to begin to calculate something about the numbers and places of production of books in the great age of paper. So in the 15th and 16th centuries, when paper and print came together for the first time, digital tools allow us to map or to visualise how print spread or how paper was disseminated throughout Northern Europe.
For those of us working in Chinese, digitization first of all means the creation of huge databases of texts that now of course are manipulable and searchable. We're looking at non-canonical, very ephemeral kinds of materials that in the past only were accessible in rare book collections. The canonical text or the canonical person that we had been working on now appears in a new light. This is the first container of the great Chinese novel Dream of Red Mansion. This is only the first half of this great novel. It's 120 chapters. There are many scholars now who rely upon digitized versions of this text for quick searching and for manipulations of the text that previously weren't possible. People will search for terminology, terms that are used. You want to know if the way language is used and applied to particular characters in the novel changes between chapter 13 and chapter 113. One of the interesting things that we discover now with the advantage of digitized texts and images is that all sorts of features of transcribed texts that we had assumed are accurate replicas of the original, in fact, are lost. And that when we can go back and see the image of the original page, we find all sorts of features of the original. These features all, of course, convey meaning.
In the EastWest Text Technologies conference that we initiated as part of a three-year project between East Asian Studies Department on Stanford campus and the medievalists, we sought to bring together four really the first time groups of scholars who work on medieval and Renaissance manuscripts produced in the West and produced principally in China, but also Japan.
We thought that doing this in the new Stanford Center on the campus of Peking University was an appropriate place to do this. The advantages of having digitalized materials were very profound and very evident in all aspects of this conference. One of the most interesting things that came to light at the conference was the discovery that the actual physical form of the manuscripts and even the physical form of the scripts written on the page has such an important effect upon the way we read, whether we're talking about the visual appearance of the Chinese calligraphy on the page or the visual appearance of the illuminated European manuscript. I think this was a point that really hit home to all of us there.
During the conference, I was the interpreter for the presentations and discussion part. I was quite impressed by the fact that we share a lot of common grounds. Although we are working in different countries, different language, different time periods.
We anticipate on both sides, on both the European side and the Chinese side. We would like to move ahead chronologically into the period when printing, the technology of printing, first becomes available, to be able to examine these early imprints, to have digital images of the pages and other features of the books is absolutely essential as we proceed.